Welcome back to our Intermediate Financial Accounting class. This section is all about the income statement. In the first two segments, we've talked about what the income statement is, why it's important, how we structured it, and then in our last segment, we started actually building an income statement. And here's the work that we started doing. So you can see we've got a good heading so that our income statement can be in good form, and then we've done the first step in our multi-step income statement, which is our net sales minus our cost of goods sold to get us a gross profit number. Now that we've got gross profit, we're going to move on to our next section, and that's our operating activities. And that's going to be this piece right here. We're going to break this down into two chunks, selling expenses and administrative expenses. A lot of companies do not. They just have one S&A expense section where they list everything together. Or in a big company, they may just list S&A expenses and that's all they provide. So it depends on the company and the information they want to give to their investors, but you have to provide some information about your selling and administrative expenses. In this case, we're going to start with our selling expenses. And you can see we're going to end up having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of those. And that's going to let us get a total selling expense. Then we're going to put in our administrative expenses, and we're going to have several of those. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 administrative expenses. And we're going to label this total administrative expenses. The reason I put all of this in is because we're going to go through our list of expenses one by one, and we're going to put them wherever we think they go. So let's go ahead then to a raw data tab. Let's start up here. Let's see. Accounts payable, not an expense. Depreciation, not an expense. Our first expense is advertising expense. Advertising expense, if we think selling versus administrative, advertising would probably be a selling expense because it's advertising. So it's part of selling my goods. So I'm going to put it up here. And again, you're welcome to link this. I'm going to type it in, but you don't have to. All right, let's go see if we can find our next one. Lots of bad debts. Ah, there's bad debt expense. Bad debt expense is the cost of people ripping us off. We sell to them on credit, and then they rip us off and never pay us. So again, because it's about our customers, it's probably also a selling expense. So we're going to put that right here. Bad debt expense. And that was $97.50. Now you'll notice here, I haven't put these numbers in as negative. It's not common to see them listed as negatives. Instead, you're taking the total sales minus a total expense. You don't really see negatives until you start getting into the gain and loss section, which we'll talk about later on. That's our bad debt expense. Let's see what's next. Building, no. I'm just looking for expense. Ah, there's depreciation. Now depreciation depends. A lot of times, depreciation expense is purely administrative. It can also be a little bit of both, but more than likely, you're depreciating your office building and computer systems, etc. So chances are, this is an administrative expense. Okay, let's see. Dividends, not an expense ever. Just thought I'd emphasize that in case you forgot. There you go. Executive salaries. Executive salaries expense, probably administrative. Salesforce salaries or wages, that will be selling expense. So executive salaries. Expense, $87,500. Let's see, expansion fund, income tax expense. Now, we're going to hold off on income tax expense. Most companies list income tax expense last. It's the last thing you see before net income. It's actually the final step in the calculation. So hold that thought. We'll come back to that one. Let's see, insurance expense. Let's go ahead and put that in. When in doubt, we kind of default to administrative. So if it's not obviously selling, then chances are it's more general and goes into administrative. And insurance is part of that group. So that kind of defaults there. Although, again, you can have insurance on your Salesforce. Sometimes this categorization, selling versus administrative, totally depends on the company. So we can go through some general examples. This usually goes here, this usually goes there, but it's going to depend on your company and how the company is structured. That's insurance expenses. See, next one, interest expense. Again, interest expense typically not included with selling and administrative because it's an expense on debt, which is not really, it's definitely not selling. We could kind of put it as administrative, but usually it's broken out just because investors look for that number, and we don't want it to get lost in that administrative section. So can you put it in administrative? You can, but we're not going to, again, just so we're showing you an example of what's common. All right, let's see. Inventory, land, loan payable, miscellaneous administrative expenses, definitely admin, and miscellaneous selling expenses, definitely selling. I'm going to go ahead and do both of those at once. So miscellaneous, $750, and we have miscellaneous selling expense up here, $97.50. I think I put that number in wrong. That debt expense. I did. $27,500. Everyone was probably very confused. I apologize. Hopefully now it looks better to you. My bad. Going through my solution too quickly and typing in the wrong number. Sorry about that. Let's see. Let's go up here to the top. Office supplies expense. Office expenses, probably administrative. So there's that number. Patents, prepaid insurance, prepaid rent. There's some rent expense. Again, rent expense could go either way. You'll also sometimes see it broken out, but more commonly it ends up in administrative. So that's where we're going to put it. Let's see, sales, we do selling commissions expense. This is part of the salary that we pay to our sales force, so that's going to be a selling expense. Let's see, next. Shipping expense. Now, again, we talked about this already, but you remember shipping expense as opposed to shipping charges. Shipping charges is our freight in. Shipping expenses is us selling or us paying to send to our customers, so that becomes a selling expense. And it looks like we're missing just one more down here. I have one blank line, so obviously I'm missing one. All right, utilities expense, $15,000. And there we go. So these are all of our selling and administrative expenses, also known as operating activities. Now that we've got all of our operating and selling activities, we're ready to do our next step. And in order to do that, I first need to add up and get a total S&A, total selling and administrative number. So sometimes you'll see this as a separate line, total selling and administrative expenses. I'm going to just break it out into this other column and take the 191 plus the 161,250, and there's my total S&A expense right here. And down here you can see that I've already, I'm going to press F2. F2 will show you your equations if you're not familiar with that cheat code. So you can see that this takes the 710 that was my gross profit minus total S&A and gives us income from operations. Gross profit tells us what we're making on each sale, what we're keeping from each sale. Income from operations takes out our day-to-day stuff. And now we're going to do kind of the abnormal line items, things that are different. They're not part of our day-to-day running the business. We're going to put our gains and losses, and then we'll put in our taxes as well. So you'll see gains and losses here. You'll also see anything that's abnormal that doesn't fit anywhere else. And that's what this company has got. Did you notice the couple things that we skipped? A couple of them we mentioned for sure, one we didn't. One was this interest expense, and one was this rent revenue. The third was income tax expense, but we're going to leave income tax expense for the time being because, again, it's that very last step is taking out taxes. So by tradition, again, you don't have to, but by tradition, the gains or abnormal revenues, they go first. So we're going to put in the rent revenue first, and then we'll put in the interest expense. So rent revenue, $62.50, and interest expense, and this time I am going to use a negative because I've got revenues and expenses in one section. Before, I had just revenues or just expenses. So again, we're going to add these up. So a total adjustment of $6,500. And this is my income from continuing operations before taxes. So you can probably guess what the next line is, right? It's our tax line. So income tax expense, and you may or may not remember, but this line was $87,852. All right, if you're caught up and ready to go and you have these numbers, I'm going to go back and mark that I've used now these three abnormal expenses. They're just not part of normal operations. That's the only thing weird about them. And now as I come back, I can do my last line, and that's net income. And you can see I've already got it marked with that double underline. That shows what's really going on. This is my final number, my key number. We're going to go ahead and stop there. When we come back, we're going to talk about some other options for presenting an income statement. We'll see you then.